the value they provide back to you in this case would be, how do I communicate with you, right? Like, who are you? What is your persona? And I don't want to spam you. I want to be like a personalized, you know, automation engine that can keep you, you know, stimulated with great content, not bother you one bit. When I have this conversation, yeah, I don't want to ask a ton of contact information, but I do want to ask critical things. I'm not willing to reduce my forms too much to sacrifice the quality of the interaction.
I think that's such a great point. Your data, so not from a data perspective as a Marketo champ managing data, right? But the perspective of someone who has data, I fill out forms, I download white papers. That data is my currency, right? So I am only going to give you as much data as I think is worth for the product that you mentioned. So if I'm going to sign up for an e-newsletter and you want to know my phone number, I'm probably not going to fill out your form. So there's a difference between number of fields too and the level of data that you're asking me to give you, the level of commitment that I feel like I'm making in giving you this information. But going back to progressive profiling, I think that's the sweet spot. Sometimes sales and marketing, historically tricky relationship to manage, right? If you pull too many of the requirements from sales and think that they're requirements for everything that you do in marketing, you may think that for every lead, you need a phone number, you need a job title, you need this role segmentation, you need their industry. But the fact is that you don't, right? The fact is, if you ask up front, the first interaction that you have with someone, you're not sending that lead to a salesperson the first time they sign up for an e-newsletter or the first time that they download your ebook. See, if you ask them questions over the course of time, you start with the role segment. The second time you see them, instead of asking for a role segment, you ask for a job title. The third time, instead of asking for either of those things, you ask for a phone number. You're building this more complete profile as you go that a salesperson can leverage. But as the person who owns the data, who's giving it away, they don't feel like they're giving it all away at once.